Effective communication is about conveying information. This can happen only if the communicator and the receiver of information start from a common basis. They need to use the same language, symbols, or images. Otherwise, recipients won't grasp the message. Marketing campaigns are costly, and the last thing companies want to do is spend money for advertising and communication that leaves consumers indifferent or puzzled. So, our goal here would be to study the 5 steps typically involved in building an effective communication campaign. First, we have to determine what the goal of the campaign is. Do we want to attract new customers, or do we want to build the awareness and preference of existing customers? The right message for the two groups would be different. To gain new customers, we have to deliver a message that presents the brand and the product, so at the very least, they know they exist. Existing customers are familiar with the product, they know how to use it, but we want to keep them around and, if possible, increase their brand loyalty. We need to communicate to them the amazing features of the product and remind them this is exactly what they're looking for and don't need anything else. The product can be shown as a lifestyle choice. This is a message that can resonate particularly strongly within a specific target audience. The second step consists of gaining an idea about the type of people we want to reach. And these are the exact same people we had in mind when creating the product, the target audience. If the target audience is made of multiple subsegments, then marketing managers must decide which one they would like to address. Once we know the goal of the campaign and its target audience, then it will be time to think of a message that would resonate with that target audience. The message must be customized in a way that is understandable, relatable, and easy to remember. Most companies hire experienced copywriters or agencies to come up with catchy marketing slogans. So, phase number 3 consists in coming up with the right message. Once we're ready, it's time to select the media channel that would allow us to reach the target audience. There are a few important parameters we need to consider. First, the information we can transmit through a TV advertisement and a billboard is different. The media channel must follow the objective of the campaign. Second, we have to think about costs. Some channels are very effective and allow you to deliver a message to millions of customers. However, it is expensive to run a TV ad, for example. Only large companies can afford to do that. So, we have to keep an eye on costs. Metrics such as cost per viewer or cost per impression are helpful and facilitate the comparison of advertising channels. The third and probably most important variable when you have to select a type of media is if your target audience consumes this type of content. So, for example, Nike advertises on TV and chooses broadcasts of sports shows and sport games. This is when their target audience is in front of TVs. We have prepared a great downloadable PDF document which compares different communication channels that can be used. Please, look at it once you complete this lesson. Step number 5 consists of producing the marketing materials. If you've chosen TV, you must shoot a TV commercial. And if you've chosen billboards or newspapers, you'll need a designer who can create a beautiful poster. Now, although most companies use the services of specialized agencies, this doesn't mean the marketing team is not involved. They have to give guidance and ensure the materials are in line with the message that must be delivered to customers.